Mike Randall, Cloquet, Minnesota, United States. Now, he had an earlier jump that was wiped out when the jury decided to shorten the run. And let's see whether or not he can prove on it. He had 90.2 points out of that first effort. Here comes Mike Randall, very promising competitor.
The track will be slower now, and I think Mike looked like he had a little bit of trouble with his timing on that, probably due to the lesser speed.
He's got 68 meters in distance. Style points coming up. He's got 70.2 points out of a bad jump. He lost 30 points from the jump that was wiped out in the second time around. So that's a big loss for Mike Randall, and I'm sure he's not very happy about it. Now back to the end run we go for Uwe Dotzauer of East Germany, one of the top contenders in the world in Nordic combined competition.
Yes, he's a strong jumper and runner.
Coming down the end run now, as they come off the end, listen, and you'll hear the wind grab them, fairly whistle.
And he's in a good end run position, very powerful entry into the air. He rolled it over well in a nice telemark landing position. He'll get good points for that jump.
81 meters. 99 and a half points for Uwe Dotzauer. Another look in slow motion.
A nice low in run position. You can see him moving forward as he nears the end of the takeoff. A quick snap and aggressively and quickly out over the ski tips. And he just keeps that forward rotation going. A beautiful, powerful jump.
Seems satisfied with it. You'll notice all of the East Germans wear those pads. They back of the foot, back of the leg, to keep them forward in the proper position. This is Sergei Trevyakov of the Soviet Union.
And again, got a low in run position. It looked like he dropped his weight a little at takeoff, but it's just still a long ride. And he had a little trouble going through the transition. He might have hit a little sticky snow.
Well, he had a whale of a jump, I'll tell you that.
He was bouncing a little bit, as we can see here. Lowered the legs and the trunk, but really came up high. I think it's due to the power that he really got down the hill well, and he rolled the last part of it well, was well extended over the skis and goes into a good
86
landing.
86 meters, 105 and a half points for Sergei Trevyakov, and that's going to put him into the lead. So now, we take another look at Pat Ahern. We saw him earlier with the jump that he lost. Now we're going to count one.
And let's see if he can do it again. Skis came up well. Not as good as the one before.
83 and a half meters. He had 112.3 in points in his first jump, the one that he lost. He gets 103.5 in this one. So he lost almost 9 points.
That's going to be very disappointing to Pat. He had an outstanding first stride.
Sergei Trevyakov, the leader right now. Another look at Pat Ahern.
Position looks good. And the timing was also good. He may have been a little slow getting out over his ski tips. Right there, he looks like he's in a fairly stable position.
103.5 for Patrick. And next up is Thomas Müller of West Germany. Right now, Ahern, with that 103.5, is in second place on the scoreboard.
Good speed, powerful takeoff. Pretty jump, nice landing.
85 meters for Thomas Müller of West Germany. 48 and a half points in style. That'll give him, in this first jump, 106.9. That moves him into the lead and drops Pat Ahern to third place.
And you can see the compression in the forward snap right there. The ski tips, the air brings the tips up, and he gradually pushes the skis over until he's in a nice aerodynamic position. Bends the knees a little early, which brought him down. He could have gotten a couple more meters out of that one.
Thomas Müller of West Germany, and he may be quite a surprise to some people because his name has not come up that much when they start talking about favorites. This is Drago Vidic, Yugoslavia.
And he brought one leg back. He's off balance, and it's a pretty hard fall there. Both skis come off, and he looks like he could be hurt.
He's down. He is not moving right now as the medical attendants rush to him. Drago Vidic of Yugoslavia really never had a chance for control because looked like, Jay, he was out of control from the very beginning.
Yes, I believe he jumped a little early. He didn't meet the air pressure right, and right here he just pulls one leg back and gets the air on top of the ski, catches an edge, turns around and the ski comes off. One of them comes off immediately. He's sliding, twisting.
Drago Vidic of Yugoslavia. There's hospital service immediately available. There's an ambulance standing by, and if necessary, there is a helicopter at hand to transport anyone out of here as swiftly as need be. So right now, the big story of the day, as we see Vidic being attended to, Thomas Müller of West Germany has the lead. Pat Ahern is right there in the hunt. But some fine jumps were canceled because they had to shorten the end run and shorten the distance.
We have completed the first round, and the weather's getting rougher and rougher. But Pat Ahern, a bit of a surprise to be where he is, and Kerry Lynch looks like he's in pretty good shape, J-Ran. But most important thing after just one jump is the fact that you get three and you score the best two. That's right. What that means is that Kerry Lynch has two more chances to score well. Pat Ahern, I think he'll keep that one. That was a nice jump.
We'll have the results of rounds two and three for you tonight here on ABC.